Sharm el-Sheikh on Tuesday hosts the fifth meeting of the Sahel and Sahara Defense Ministers, which of course continues until March the 25th. The meeting gathers with ministers from 27 Arab African states as well as five European countries. Now on the sidelines of the meeting, Nile TV's correspondent Linda Abdul Latif held this interview with the Nigerian Chief of Army Staff Tukur Buratai.
Joined right now by Lieutenant General Tukur Buratai, who's Nigeria's Chief of Army Staff. Your Excellency, thank you so much for being with us today, Nile TV International.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased to be here.
Let's start off first with the efforts of the Nigerian government in order to counter terrorism or Boko Haram that have been committing a number of terrorist attacks in Nigeria.
Thank you very much. The efforts of the government of Nigeria in tackling the insurgency in the northeast has been quite commendable. The necessary support, the will is there. Mr. President has, the first day he assumed the leadership of the country, he directed the military command and control center to be moved from the capital Abuja to the northeast. This was the first political move that really brought about the succeeding efforts to transform the fight against the Boko Haram terrorists and the subsequent defeat of these terrorists, which to a greater extent by now we have now degraded them, and we have the initiative, and the government has given us all the necessary logistic support to prosecute this war. And the second major political decision, and indeed to underscore Mr. President's, that President Muhammadu Buhari's political will, was the directive to bring the Boko Haram terrorists to an end by December of last year. This was a great move, and we were able to pursue that directive to its logical conclusion. To the extent that by the end of that deadline, we'll be able to degrade the Boko Haram terrorists. But you know, generally, the issue of terrorism has different ramifications. And the issue of suicide bombing, it's another ramification, it's another dimension. But the terrorists now, to carry arms and move from one location to the other, to gain territories or to capture territories, has long been crushed, and they don't have the ability to do that. We're now following them from one area to the other to ensure that we clear them finally. But by and large, we have done a lot, and we are still doing more.
And how has the African Coalition Force been successful in combating Boko Haram in Nigeria?
The African what?
Coalition Force.
Coalition, or the multinational joint task force. Well, you see, the leadership of the multinational joint task force is on Nigeria. The commander is provided by Nigeria, and so far it's been doing very well. The Cameroonian troops are doing very well in the eastern border, as well as to the southern border of Borno State, as well as the Nigerian troops also are doing very well. The Chadian troops also along the Lake Chad waters are also making headway. We've been able to box them with these efforts. with the Nigerian side that is right within the Nigerian territory. We are pushing them, and from the Cameroonian side, and Niger and Chad are also boxing them up. Efforts have been made to ensure that joint operations are conducted so that these terrorists are also routed from the border towns along these countries.
Finally, sir, how do you see the importance of holding the defense ministers' meeting of the South Saharan countries that will take place on Thursday and Friday as well?
Well, as you can see, we are here today as a prelude to the ministers of defense meeting of the CENSAT countries. This is a positive development. As you all know, terrorism is a global phenomenon. And here in Africa, especially the Sahara and Sahel countries, we've been having this challenge for some time. And it's a good development that the ministers of defense of the CENSAT are coming to put heads together to work towards elimination of terrorism and other forms of crimes, including cross-border banditry, drug trafficking, and the rest. It's a positive development. We're happy about that. This is another step in the right direction, just like the multinational joint task force brought about by the Lake Chad Basin Commission countries. This CENSAT is another broader and bigger community that will look at it in a global African perspective, where you see these terrorists cross borders. They go beyond one border or the other, and they go around getting arms, recruiting more. If these countries come together to block these aspects of smuggling of arms, trafficking of persons, this will really greatly contribute towards curtailing terrorism across our borders. So it's a welcome development.
Your Excellency, thank you so much for being with us today on Nile TV.
Thank you, Linda. Happy. All right. Cheers.